couch.me. The lessons. Hello, my friend, and welcome to the wonderful world of guitar music. You're in for a spectacular journey, and you're gonna make incredible discoveries every time you pick up your guitar. So in some ways, I envy you, and I wish you a terrific musical journey. And I'm making this video because I want to alleviate some of your concerns. The guitar world has many paths that you can choose. And I'm here to tell you that you can choose all of them. You don't have to choose just one. Some people will tell you that if you play electric guitar, you can play classical guitar. And if you play classical guitar, then obviously you can't be an electric guitar player. Some people will tell you that you have to wear certain clothes or grow your hair long or grow a beard or grow your fingernails or whatever. And this is all irrelevant. It's irrelevant. The only thing that's relevant to your personal guitar journey is what you want to play and who you are. Because the guitar world is a rich, spectacular, fantastic world full of music. And music is the key. But because the guitar is such a dazzling instrument, let's call it that, because it's such a dazzling instrument, the marketing aspect of the guitar world is focused more about the players rather than the instrument itself. And that kind of skews the view of beginner guitar players, and then it creates unnecessary pressure. And this is what I want to help you with, even before you start playing, or if you're just starting out. How to play guitar? That's the question, right? This is the video. The way you want to play guitar is your way of playing guitar. There's no right and wrong technique, other than technique that makes you work hard and makes your hands hurt, okay? Any other thing, any other technique, as long as it produces the sound that you want to hear, that's a good technique. Some of the biggest names in guitar, Pat Metheny, okay? Steve Morse, even Stanley Jordan, obviously, because he's using both hands to tap. He did it long before YouTube. He did it back in the 80s. They were all playing wrong. Pat Metheny holds the pick with three fingers and his thumb. Same goes to Steve Morse. Steve Morse picks something like this, and he's one of the most accurate players. And you're gonna hear that there's only one way to do things, only one way to hold the guitar, only one way to pick, only one way to produce a sound, and that's complete nonsense. That's nonsense. There are many, many ways to produce a sound on the guitar, as there are many genres of guitar music. Okay, for example, flamenco music. They hit the strings. They hit the strings as hard as they can. They abuse the strings. And before flamenco music came along, what existed was classical music. And for classical musicians, flamenco musicians used the guitar wrong, and they played using a wrong technique, and they used their fingers wrong, and they soloed wrong, and the sound was all wrong. But guess what? There's no such thing. There's no such thing as wrong in music. And unfortunately, most musicians, but most guitar players, I don't know why, but most guitar players are very, very they have a closed mind view of the guitar for some reason. I have yet to understand why. But most guitar players tend to choose one genre, one type of guitar, and then decide that everything else is wrong. And I say experiment. You might discover something that you've never heard of. Experiment, listen to different music, not just guitar music. It will open your ears. And then try to play it on guitar, okay? Try to sound like a saxophone. Try to sound like a piano when you play. Try to sound like a drummer, okay? Try to be percussive. Try to create new sounds. That's how new musicians come along. That's how groundbreaking musicians come along. You might be the next groundbreaking musician. Don't let anybody tell you that you're playing wrong. Okay, unless your guitar is off key and your strings are rusted and you scratch the guitar when you pick. But that's not a good example either, because you'll see that Tommy Emmanuel's guitar is heavily scratched, and Eric Clapton's guitar is heavily scratched, and guitars have scratches and bumps, and sometimes you have a crack in your guitar, but that's irrelevant. That's all irrelevant. All that's important is you and what you want to play. I already made a video similar to this called My Best Advice to Beginner Guitar Players. And that revolved more about choosing the right teacher and playing what you want to hear and what and the music that you want to play. But even before that, this is why I'm making this video. Even before you start playing, you have to realize that many people are going to tell you irrelevant things. You don't have to grow your hair long. You don't have to wear black clothes. You don't have to grow your fingernails unless you want to play flamenco or classical music. You don't have to use a specific pick. Okay, try different picks. You have thin picks. You have thick picks. You have small picks, large picks, extra large picks. You can experiment. Okay, don't just because your teacher plays a certain way doesn't mean A, that they're good players. That's the most important thing to know. Most teachers are not very good players. They might be terrific teachers, but if they tell you play like me, something is wrong. Any teacher that tells you no, you have to play the way I do, throw them out and get a new teacher. A teacher that will help you find your own voice. Okay? Try different picks, different sounds, try different strings, different guitars, okay? Play something that's supposed to be played on a classical, play it on acoustic. Play something that's supposed to be played on an electric guitar, try to play it on a classical. Try to play it on an acoustic. Try to play it on a ukulele. You might be surprised what you hear, what you get. Okay, don't let anybody tell you that there's one way of doing things. Okay, because there's not. There are new discoveries every day, and you can discover new ways. You might be the one to discover a completely new way to play the guitar. Okay, the slide, for example. You play the slide is a completely different way to play than anything else. Okay, and that's blasphemy in the eyes of classical musicians. And classical musicians believe that classical music and the classical guitar is the only guitar to be played. I've met many of these people, unfortunately. But the truth of the matter is that most classical musicians are awful guitar players. They have great technique, okay? They might sound perfect, but they're boring. They're boring. Everything they play sounds the same. They lack spirit. There's no spirit to what they play. So how can they call themselves musicians? They're merely technicians. And there are many electric guitar players who can shred and they can tear up the guitar and they can play 3,000 notes a second, but they're not making music. They're merely playing exercises. So what I'm trying to say is, it's not the guitar, it's the player. It's not the instrument, it's you. It's your ears, it's your spirit, it's your vision, and it's your music, okay? So as you go into guitar music, remember this. You can keep your hair short, you can shave, you can grow your fingernails, you can cut your fingernails, you can abuse your guitar, you can treat it gently, you can play, you can mix the two. Okay, you can play gently and then you can strum loudly. Don't be afraid of tearing strings. Don't be afraid of hitting the guitar with such force that a string would break. Just replace the string. Don't be afraid of alternate tunings, okay? Or as I like to call them, wrong tunings, because you might stumble on an accidental tuning. I'll make a lesson on that one day. Accidental tunings. That's what I have to say to you. And I wish you a terrific musical journey. And as I said, I envy you, because every time you're going to pick up the guitar, every time you'll play a new chord or even a wrong chord, because there's no such thing as a wrong chord. Okay, if you play this, then it's just a jazz chord. It's just a chord with extensions, with extra notes. That's all it is. You'll just as you love the beautiful chords, Okay. Yeah, the beautiful chords, the basic chords. You learn to love the ugly chords as well. Okay, you learn to love, okay, the weird chords. You learn to love the outside sound. You'll develop your ear, okay? There's beauty everywhere. Everywhere you look, there's beauty. And any note you play is beautiful. Learn to hear it. Just learn to hear the beauty of what you play. Yeah, the dog is dreaming, and I bet it's beautiful dreams. So thank you very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you want to. This channel is for more advanced players, but you'll get there. You'll get there. So thank you very much, and enjoy. Have fun.